Let's talk about solving compound inequalities. So I've started off with two sets here. I'm calling the sets A and B. So the set A consists of everything inside this circle, that is these six numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 numbers. And everything inside of B consists of these five numbers, 3, 0, -1, 1/2, and 4. And the numbers are associated with a little point right here. So we have a way of combining these two sets in special ways to give new sets. And the first way of combining them is called intersection, and it's denoted like this. A intersect B. Okay, so when you see that symbol right there, that denotes what we call intersection. So intersection. And intersection, all you have to know about that is it basically means overlap. Okay, so it's the numbers belonging to both sets. There's another way, and it's called union. And it's denoted like this, A union B. So that right there, when you see that, that's called union in math. And all you have to know about that is it basically means all. Okay, all of the members belonging to A or B. Up here, intersection, the overlap of the sets A and B. So for the example I gave with these two circles here, what is the intersection? What is A intersect B? Well, let's see. It denotes overlap, right? And where's the overlap? It's right in here. So the new set would be consisting of the numbers 3 and 0, because that's the overlap of A and B. Now let's think about the union of these two sets. Now union simply means all, right? So any number belonging to either set. So it's going to be everything. It's going to be 1, 6, 5, negative 2, 3, 0, negative 1, negative, we'll make that positive 1/2, and 4. Okay, so these would be all, these numbers are all the numbers belonging to either set. So union is basically everything, okay? And intersection is strictly the overlap. Okay, let's take these ideas now and extend them to intervals. So I drew two more sets here, A, and A is given on a number line, right? It's all the numbers greater than negative 2. And B, I gave that set on a number line as well. And it's all the numbers less than 5. So let's go ahead and go through what we talked about a moment ago. What is, well, A intersect B? Well, remember, intersect is overlap, right? And do you see the overlap of these two sets? Well, clearly it's all the numbers between negative 2 and 5, right? Because intersection means the numbers have to belong to both sets. And we write that set in interval notation. So negative 2 to 5. This is all the numbers between negative 2 and 5. And now union of these two sets. Well, remember, union is basically any number that belongs to either set. It's basically all the numbers in the set. Or all the numbers in either set. So when I look at this, well, do you see how every number is included in one of these sets? The union of these two sets is going to be negative infinity to infinity, because every real number, which is what this denotes, every real number is included in one of these sets. Now, it turns out that you can see that the top set refers to or is the solution set of the inequality X is greater than negative 2. That's the top set, right? That's for A. And B is X is less than 5. Now, we have a special way when you have two inequalities. We have a special way of telling you that we want you to think about the intersection of the corresponding solution sets. And here's the word we use. We write AND. Okay? So when you see AND, that's going to mean intersection. In other words, AND tells you that you want to find both solution sets and find the intersection of those sets. Okay, so we're looking at this. X greater than negative 2 and x less than 5, the intersection is the overlap, right? So it's negative 2 to 5, okay? Because it's basically my answer up here, right? It's the intersection of the sets of these, of the solution sets for these two inequalities. Now, if you want to denote union, here's what we write. X greater than negative 2, we still have that, and we still have x is less than 5. But we don't use and, we use a different word. And the other word is or. Okay, so when you see or, that means union. So if somebody says, okay, you know, solve x greater than negative 2 or x less than 5, they want you to think about the union. And the union of those two sets, as we saw up here, is negative infinity to infinity. Okay, so from here on, from henceforth, and will mean intersection, and or will mean union. Okay, let's try an example making use of that new terminology. Okay, so here we're asked to solve 2x minus 3 is less than negative 1, and negative 3 times x minus 2 is less than 9. Okay, so the first thing I note is that I see the and that makes me think right away of intersection. Okay, so the way we do this is we handle each inequality separately. So let's write it out here. 2x minus 3 less than negative 1, okay? And then and, right next door to it, we have the other one. Negative 3 times x minus 2 is less than 9. Okay, so here we go. We're going to add 3 to both sides here for the first one. And we get 2x is less than positive 2. And now we're going to divide both sides by 2. And we get x is less than 1. Okay? And, right? And, let's see what happens with the next one. Well, negative 3x plus 6 is less than 9. And subtracting 6 from both sides, we get negative 3x is less than positive 3. And now we're going to divide both sides by negative 3. But whenever you divide both sides by negative, what do you have to do? That's right. You've got to flip the inequality. So it's going to be x is greater than negative 1. Okay, so here's what we have. We have x is less than 1 and x is greater than negative 1. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to consider both of these sets, right? First of all, x is less than 1. So let's go ahead and get a number line for that. Okay, less than 1. So here's 1. And we want the numbers less than 1, right? So we want all the numbers this way. So I'm shading on the number line going to the left. And now let's get a number line for the next one. X is greater than negative 1. So I have a number line right below it. And negative 1, let's put that over here. And being, you know, greater than negative 1 means to the right of negative 1, as we know. So I put a parenthesis on that negative 1 and I shade to the right. And then here's the important part. I see that the what we call the connector, the word in between, is and. Now that means the intersection of these two sets. And that means the overlap. And that's why the answer to this problem is negative 1 to 1. Okay, so we had to solve basically each inequality separately and then, you know, create their corresponding or represent their corresponding solution sets on number lines. And the final step, of course, and the new step is considering the word in between. And if the word is and, you want to take the overlap or the intersection. But if the word was or, I would have considered the union. Okay, let's try another one like that. Okay, so let's solve 3x is less than 6 or 2x is greater than 8. So once again, let's take these off to the side. So 3x is less than 6 or 2x is greater than 8. Okay, dividing both sides by 3 for the first one. We get x is less than 2. And for the other one, what do we get? Well, dividing both sides by 2, we get x is greater than 4. Okay, so once again, draw both sets individually. So let's do that. So here's 2. Now x is less than 2, right? So a parenthesis on that 2 and shading to the left. And for the next one, x is greater than 4. Okay, so 4. Now when you do this, you want to make sure that these number lines are lined up properly. So what I mean by that is 4 lies to the right of 2, and I want that order to be respected when I put these number lines one on top of the other, right? Like, in other words, 2 should lie to the left of 4 on the top number line, and 4 should be to the right of 2 on the lower number line. Okay, so for this second number line, x is greater than 4, that means to the right of 4, right? So parenthesis on the 4, shading to the right. Okay, 4 is not included, it's a parenthesis there. Okay, now we go back and we say, what's the connector? What's the word? And the word is or. Now, or means union, and union means basically you want all the numbers that you see. Well, clearly I want all of these numbers, right? So that's going to be negative infinity all the way to 2. But I also want all of these numbers, right? And that's going to be 4 to infinity. Now, when you have two intervals, but there's a gap in between, we use a special symbol to denote that gap. And here's the symbol. We write union. That tells your reader that you want all of these numbers together with all of those numbers. One giant collection here. Okay, so we use this symbol whenever we have a gap between two intervals. Okay, let's try another one here. Okay, so this is a special type of compound inequality. And the reason is because you basically have one line, but with two inequality symbols. So let's write that off here. Negative 3 less than 2x plus 7 is less than or equal to 5. Okay, this is an example of what's called a double inequality. Double inequality. Now, a double inequality is really two inequalities in one. And here they are. It's negative 3 is less than 2x plus 7. That's the first one, okay? And even though you don't see the word, there's really a word that's there that's understood to be and. And 2x plus 7 is less than or equal to 5. So nobody ever takes this and writes it out like that. But this is how you can think about it. Now, the way we actually technically solve these is we isolate the variable in the middle. So for example, if I want to get that x by itself, what would I do first? Well, I'd subtract 7, right? Now when you do that, you also have to subtract 7 from both of the other sides as well. Not just one of them, but both of them. So let's see, when we get that, or when we do that, what do we get? Negative 10 is less than 2x is left in the middle, and on the right-hand side, it's going to be less than or equal to negative 2. And now to get the x by itself, let's divide by 2. But of course, whatever you do to the middle, you have to do to the right and to the left. Okay, because we're solving two inequalities at once. Okay, negative 10 divided by 2 is negative 5 less than x less than or equal to negative 1. And now when we look at this, this notation is very suggestive, right? It's telling us that x lies between negative 5 and negative 1. That is, x is greater than negative 5, but at the same time, less than or equal to negative 1. And so the way we write that in interval notation is like this. Between negative 5 and negative 1. Now, I need a bracket on the negative 1 because it's less than or equal to negative 1. Okay, so all of the examples we've done in this video have been examples of what are called compound inequalities. And a compound inequality is basically when you have two inequalities and they're connected by either and or one of those two situations. And sometimes you have what's called a double inequality, and those are really and compound inequalities in disguise. Okay, until next time.